today we're going to bring you a multi-part video series that talks about how we were able to burst a balloon to get these kind of results like this with a digital camera. It's going to involve flashes and cameras. Okay, go ahead. And drums. There'll be drums at the end of every video because my director and producer insist upon it. So how you go about doing this? It's pretty easy. A lot of people think that you use a camera and you try to press the button at just the right moment, and that's completely not the case. What you do is take a long exposure photograph, or maybe not quite too long, but 3 to 5 seconds, or 1 to 3 seconds, somewhere in there. So we'll say 1 to 5 seconds could be your shutter actuation time. You actually use the flash to be your shutter, because the flash of light is actually much quicker than what a DSLR can stop action at. So a typical DSLR will have 1/4,000th of a second shutter speed, or 1/8,000th of a second shutter speed, 1/8,000th being the fastest pro level and mid-summer grade DSLRs. Whereas a flash can go from 1/20,000th of a second up to 1/35,000th of a second. Now there are flashes that go up to 1/1,000,000th, 1/2,000,000th of a second. They're very expensive and we don't have it. We're just talking about a speed light that you know, a typical Canon, Yongnuo, Nikon speed light that you would buy from Walmart or Target or wherever you'd buy, Amazon.com, wherever you'd buy your speed light. So we're gonna get in a dark room, turn off the lights, shoot a pellet gun at a balloon, and at a precise moment, flash the speed lights, and they will stop the pellet and the balloon burst in their tracks to give you a nice, good picture with great results.